The Sri Lankan government says it's banning the burqa to ensure national security. Muslims see that and the closing of Islamic schools as another way of marginalising their community in the majority Buddhist country. But the Minister of Public Security is unapologetic.
It affects our national security directly. In our early days, Muslim women and girls never wore the burqa. It is a sign of religious extremism that came about recently. We are definitely going to ban it. Also, there are more than 2,000 madrasa schools in the country. Nobody can open a school and teach whatever you want to the children. From ages 5 to 6, all children must study in accordance with the national education policy.
The wearing of the burqa was temporarily banned in 2019 after the bombing of churches at Easter by alleged Islamic militants killed more than 250 people. Activists say the decision to make the ban permanent is actually not a surprise. Justice Minister Ali Sabri, who is Muslim, hinted at it shortly after the government reversed its policy on forced cremation of COVID-19 victims following international criticism. But there's no doubt this latest move will increase tensions further with the Muslim minority in Sri Lanka.
At a time where the Muslim community has been constantly targeted, it's part of Islamophobic reaction in Sri Lanka. They just lifted the ban on burial. Compulsory cremation policy was revised, and now we hear so many other measures to some form of punishing the Muslim community.
President Gotabaya Rajapaksa has also signed new laws under the Prevention of Terrorism Act, which will allow anyone suspected of what the government terms extremism to be detained for what it calls rehabilitation for up to 2 years. The government has denied its targeting Muslims, but many believe that's exactly what's behind these new moves. Minelle Fernandez, Aljazeera, Colombo.